Hello folks, and welcome to another episode of Absolute Match Fishing. My name's Matt Godfrey and you join me today at the beautiful Woodlands View Fishery near Droitwich. With me I've got two expert match anglers. The first is Miss Emma Pickering. She's a full England Ladies International and she won the World Championships in 2008. The next is Mr. Lee Kerry, another England International angler that fishes for the mighty Barnsley Blacks team. They're both going to be using some different tactics today and I'm really excited to see what they're doing. Hopefully they'll help you catch more fish. Let's crack on and see what they're up to. Here we are folks, it's time for the all important draw. I've got Lee Kerry, I've got Emma Pickering and there's peg 6 and peg 7 to choose from. Normally we'd toss a coin or draw a peg from the hat, maybe even use the magic stone like last time. But seeing as we've got a lady fishing today, I think it's only fair we do the good old fashioned ladies first. So we've got peg 6 and we've got peg 7.
I'll have 6 then, Matt.
How rude. I think I'll have peg 6.
All right then, I'm on 7 obviously.
So Emma's on peg 6, Lee Kerry, you're on peg 7. You're both going to be doing a few different things today. I'm excited to see what we're going to catch. Let's go get set up. Few seconds before the start of the match now. There's plenty of fish moving about on top. I'm sure we'll see some red hot action. I'm going to give them the shout in a few seconds. Are we ready, guys?
Yeah,
all in! Both our anglers have started fishing now, and what is interesting is that they've both chosen to fish with rod and line at the start of the session. Lee's started on a waggler, Emma's started on a little pellet feeder, and I'm sure that they're both going to catch plenty of fish. I'm going to go down, have a chat with them shortly, and find out why they've decided to start on this, and hopefully they'll change methods and we'll see them try different things throughout the day and catch plenty of fish along the way. First fish of the day there, then Lee on the waggler.
Good start, eh, mate?
Lovely fish. How big is that?
Well, it's about £5, but we'll tell. It's £10. £10 that one, Matt.
£10.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah. So well, you know, bit of gamesmanship, I think.
Bit of pressure on her.
Bit of pressure on her. Yeah.
Too right.
I need every help I can get, to be honest.
Let's not tell her. Let's not tell her.
And £4, £5, something like that.
Lovely little fish, anyway.
Yeah, nice fish, mate. Yeah. Just slip that one in.
So Lee, you've started the session on the waggler.
Yeah.
I can see lots of fish cruising about, but why have you actually done that?
Well, the thing is, Matt, sometimes on commercial, especially like pressured ones such as this that get fished a lot, the fish, when everybody walks around at the start of the match, a lot of fish back out into the middle of the lake.
Okay.
So I thought to myself, you've got two options really. You can start short and look for a fish short, or you can go to where the fish are. I'm not so sure how good it's going to be today, and there's a lot of pressure on me to try and beat Emma. So I thought to myself, if I can nick a couple of fish early in the middle of the lake on the waggler, that's going to be, you know, a great start.
Yeah, settle you into the day sort
of thing. Yeah, absolutely. And all the time, because I've got some other methods on the pole, I can feed them and prime them up whilst I'm fishing that line further out. So I can keep, if I can keep nicking a few fish, then hopefully it'll be good. And also, waggler's good for some big ones. Yeah. Often get a big one on
the big
waggler.
Crafty one.
I fancy a crafty one today on waggler, mate.
Nice. I mean, just let's have a little quick look at your setup, shall we? Well,
yeah,
it's,
I mean,
dead simple
it,
to me.
It is so simple, Matt, especially like waggler fishing these days. I've just got a 4 gram pellet waggler. It's already loaded. Dead simply, I've just held it in place with two of those sliding line stops on like an 020 main line.
Right.
No problem with fishing in a thick main line because there's plenty of weight in the float to cast. And then I've got an 015 hook length with a 16 PR36 on the hook and just a banded pellet. There's no shot down the line, loop to loop connection, it's all dead easy. If I wanted to change the waggler at any point, all I'd do is just literally unclip my clip and pop a bigger waggler on.
If a bit of wind gets up.
Yeah, a bit of wind gets up or something like that. At the moment, it's looking fantastic. So hopefully, if I just keep, you know, when it go in, I don't want it to just dive in, so I try and feather it in. And with this setup, it's all simple, no weaknesses in the line. I can really give it some stick.
Lovely stuff. Well, let's get back out. Let me see you catch another one.
Sounds like a good idea, yeah.
There you go. It makes a nice little plop when it goes in the water.
Yeah, yeah. I fancy one on this cast mount. That looks good. That does.
It does. See, when you fire your pellets, you just fire them just this side of your float. And
That's right. I literally just fire my pellets. When I cast out, I want the noise to try and attract an initial fish. So I cast past where my baited area is, just not a long way past, or a metre or so, just see if I can nick one off the back of the main feed. And then I just a couple of winds back into the feed. And you notice I'm quite patient with it. I'm not casting in and winding in all the time. I don't think that's always going to be the best way. You know, I think sitting and waiting and a lot of the time the cruising fish just come in and you know, nick an odd fish. Yeah. So,
and like you say, if they're a little bit bigger than what other people are catching, you don't need to catch them as quick anyway.
That's right. You know, if you can, you know, nick an odd bigger one, especially like I say on the waggler, then it, you know, it makes a big difference. So,
right, I'm here with Emma, and you've got off to a pretty good start, haven't you?
Yeah, it's been pretty good actually. I think I've snuck the lead so far.
I do as well, and it's put you in a good position, because obviously the winner from today gets an early draw in the prestigious Absolute Match Fishing Cup final in the final episode. So if you can keep it going.
Let's hope it's me. I'm getting plenty of indications anyway.
We've just had two or three little bites then, haven't we?
There's plenty of fish about. I've just had a good little run.
It's interesting you've started on a feeder. I mean, Lee's fished a waggler, you've fished a feeder, both rod and line, but he's fishing up in the water and you're fishing on the bottom. So why have you chose to start on the feeder?
The main reason, really, there's loads of fish swimming about, and to be honest, it's a hot day. I just think they're basking, and I think somewhere in the water is going to be feeding fish. And being a pickering, there's only one method we use, really.
Of course it is. I mean, you're a daughter of Mr. Tommy Pickering, who's the captain of the England feeder team, so...
Yeah, so he's taught me a trick or two, but it's not method feeder today, it's pellet feeder. Obviously, fishery rules, you're not allowed to fish a method feeder, but it seems to be going well. I'm swapping between an 8 and 6 mil pellet on the hook, just to give a bit of variation for the fish. And just
We're into a fish now. You can see that, you didn't really strike then, it just pulled your rod around, you picked up and...
Yeah, they just stuck themselves, to be honest with you. There's no need to be striking at little indications and things like that. Just literally let them rip the rod off the rest. And that one's come off.
Oh, no.
That's about right. You're bad luck for me, you know,
Matthew. I think I can see Lee Kerry laughing around the other side of that tree, Emma.
We could push him in?
Yeah.
I think so, too.
I'll tell you what, before we cast back out, let's have a little look at your setup that you've got.
It's really simple, to be honest. I've got a short hook clip. I started off with one about that long.
Sort of 4 inches.
Yeah, but I sort of bumped a few fish off, so I've put one on a bit longer.
Right.
I've just got a 16 hook on, 12-15, with a band on.
Nice, simple.
Yeah, swapping between a 6mm and 8mm pellet.
And that's the pellet feeder you're talking about there.
Yeah, it's free running, obviously, to a quick change bead.
Yeah.
And I'm just plugging my pellets in. I'll just show you.
You've just soaked a few up, I take it, so they just...
Yeah, so I'm plugging a few in there, I'm popping my hook bait in. Plugging a few more.
That's lovely, and I suppose the carp come along, it's all in a little ball of feed, and they suck it all up, and your hook bait's amongst it, and there's one on.
The advantage of a pellet feeder as well, with the method, and sort of like the banjo, we have it as a dinner plate, as me and my dad call it. And the fish can come in at all angles to feed, but with this they can only come in at one angle
because it's got the little open end.
Yeah, so they home in at one angle and they're straight on.
Well, it's certainly working today, and it's a nice, easy, simple way of fishing.
It is.
How many have you got now? You've got 8, I make it, haven't you?
How many have Lee got?
I reckon he's got 3 or 4. So we're smashing it up.
It's all
at the
good
minute.
At the minute.
Yeah,
I'm liking this.
Looks good, and you sank your line there, didn't you? You cast out. Put your tip under the water. Do you think that's important?
It is. It's really, really important. Obviously, major key with feeder fishing. Once it's in the water, don't move the feeder. Obviously, sink your line under the water. And what all I do is feed it through my fingers till I can see all my line sunk. And if you're fishing the process of that happening, it takes the line out of your hands anyway, so you know it's on. And it's lovely when that happens.
Nice. Just a few little indications there. Are they line bites, Emma? Or?
I think it's fish attacking the feeder. I think there's a lot of F1s out there. I've had sort of 5 F1s and three stocky carp, so I just think they're attacking the feeder, and it'll go round in a minute.
Nice. Let's hope it's a big one.
Yeah, I need a couple of big ones, I reckon.
I don't know. You're looking good to me so far.
Lee Carey's just had his second fish, run straight through my swim. I'm having some amazing indications from it. But he's just got a few wild ones on at the moment. He's just managed to control it now. And hopefully I'm going to catch one. But it's pure sabotage.
I know that you're catching, but have you primed any more lines? What are you thinking in your mind? Are you going to try something else, or what will happen as the session progresses?
Yeah, I mean, one of the things that I think a lot of match anglers do is make sure that they don't have just one line. So obviously we started on a waggler and now we're catching well on a pole. If I'm being honest, Matt, I don't feel that this is a winning method. I feel that the fish are quite small and they're nice to catch and build a bit of a weight with,
yeah,
but they're not winning fish. In order to catch a winning weight, I would say you probably want to look to try and catch some bigger carp, and the best way to do that is either going to be short or in the margins.
And so, what have you gone for today?
Well, I've gone for in the margins, and if I'm being quite honest, I don't think that you need to feed the margins a long time before going on them.
That's an interesting point. So you've not put any bait there?
No, I've not fed anything there at all. I've just literally left the sort of area of the lake I want to fish to be a bit more relaxed, and sort of give the fish a bit of confidence to come in and be looking, and I don't really want to feed them while I'm not catching them. So what I've looked to do is leave my peg, and I'm sort of given an area of my peg where I feel like I'm going to catch later on, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to feed there about an hour or so before I'm going to go on it. Not as much as that, Matt, to be honest. Probably more like 20 minutes, half an hour before I'm thinking, right, I'm going to see if there's any fish down the edge. I'll be potting my first amount of bait down the side and see if I can see if I can encourage fish to come in down there and see if I can encourage fish to feed. So that's basically what I'm going to do.
Well, I'll tell you what, Lee, you're catching really well shallow now, and Emma's slowed down. I think it's going to be close at this moment in time, but it's worth saying you've took on sort of a three-pronged attack to your swim today, haven't you? You've started on the waggler, now you're catching really well on the pole, and you've explained that you're probably going to think about going down the margins for the final hour of the session.
Yeah, that's it. What I'm going to do is hopefully catch those match-winning fish down the margins late on. But at this moment in time, this is keeping me going until I feel those fish will start feeding. You know, those margin fish, unless you're on for a massive weight, are unlikely to feed down the margins all day.
Yeah.
So you can almost, you know, start fishing now, keeping those fish coming, and then hopefully just catch a few fish down the edge late on.
Right. Know. We're well into the match now, folks, and I've just come back and joined Emma, and she's changed tactics, and you're now fishing short, Emma, aren't you?
I am, mate, yeah. The pellet feeder line sort of dried up a little bit, which I thought it would. And I've seen Lee sneaking a few fish shallow. My main attack on the pole was to fish short on the deck. I'm basically big cupping it.
Yeah.
Try and keep the fish in a neat area and try and keep them on the bottom. I'm thinking with loose feeding, it's going to bring them up in the water.
Right,
which I don't want. You get silly bites and that's when you foul up your fish. So I've been big cupping it. And I've been getting the odd one, to be fair, but it's just gone a little bit quiet. I've got my bite there. I've just changed and I've put a big 8mm pellet banded on the hook.
A bit of a larger target hook bait, sort of.
Yeah, and I've just had two straight away doing it, and they were bigger stamp fish as well, so I think it's actually picked the bigger fish out in my peg.
Right, well that's interesting, because I've just been sat with Lee, and I honestly thought that you took an early lead, Lee probably's clawed it back, and maybe I thought he'd got in front.
Yeah.
But looking at the size of his fish, they're all sort of 6-ounce crucians and odd little stocky carp.
Right.
But I've just watched you land three fish probably £6 a piece. So
yeah, I mean, I thought his big were fish. These fish were bigger than that, to be honest. So
no, he's got a lot of small ones, so I think it'll be a lot tighter than.
We could be necking them.
Yeah, let's catch some more big ones.
Come on, fishers.
Well, the English weather's certainly held up today, and in fact, I think it's probably the hottest day of the year so far, and it's certainly had an effect on the fishing. Earlier on, it was flat calm, and Lee struggled to get bites when he was fishing up in the water, but a little breeze got up, and it caused a little bit of ripple on the surface, and he settled into some red hot action, caught some really nice fish, all sorts of different species, fishing pellets, shallow. But obviously, the warm weather has warmed the margins of the lakes up, and now we're approaching the end of the match and both anglers are targeting their margins. They're both doing it a little bit different. Lee's catching much better than Emma now. He's got 6 or 8 really big carp and there's still nearly an hour left. I've got Lee down as taking the lead now, but 3 or 4 big carp could pull Emma right back into it. So it's exciting stuff and it'll be interesting to see who wins at the weigh-in.
It's been a tough match, but I think the one of the important things today has been trying to keep fish coming. So in that middle period when I was quite lucky to be on a method where I was catching some fish, some nice crucians and small F1s, that gave me an opportunity to keep feeding some bait down the edge. And then hopefully, like you can see now, towards the last bit, the bigger carp have come in and I've kept catching them. So although it's going to be, you know, everybody's going to catch some bigger fish down the edge, if you've caught for the duration of the match, that's what can make the difference. And I think that's probably what's going to make the difference today. Although you never know, it could be close. I think it is close, so we'll have to wait and see.
I think the first hour I got it right by sticking to my guns and fishing the pellet feeder. It worked really, really well for me. And I seemed to take a good lead in the start, but the middle of the match, I've tried to catch a few bigger fish, and I think Lee took the right approach by trying to catch everything in his peg when it went a bit difficult, and that's probably where I slipped up a little bit, opting to try and catch the carp, and he's just caught everything. But like I say, this last hour's been pretty good, so I think it's neck and neck.
Seems what I predicted was right. Emma's had 3 or 4 big carp in the last few minutes of the match, but I reckon it might be too late because I make that just about time. All out! Well, this is it, the all important weigh-in. Emma's first to weigh. Is your big fish net, Emma, or?
Yeah, I've got a lot of these down the edge. Quite honest, to be honest.
A skimmer.
A bit squeaky.
Yeah. I'm going to be generous, Emma. I'm going to say that is £34.8. There you go, mate. Do you want to slip them back? Come on then, Emma, fetch your second net up.
Oh, the old
big net.
My
lash.
Big fish net is the other one. Oh yeah, that old chestnut. Well done.
Chuck him a bar of soap, he can have a bath while he's there.
Oh. That's not a bit funny.
And that's pulled around a little bit further.
Well done.
I'm gonna say £53.8. Well done, Emma.
Well done, Emma.
Cracking net of fish. So £53.8. I make that a total of £88 exactly. A cracking net of fish and well fished, Emma.
Good, mate.
Big fish or little fish, Mr. Kerry, this one?
Well, I can't say after what Emma pulled then.
I hope that's a big one, mate.
Ooh, it looks like there's a few more in there, Emma.
Just wanted to wet me for the sake of
that. Lee Kerry's first way.
Oh, it's squeaking.
Tell you what, they're not settling down. I'm going to give that £53 exactly.
Oh, good. What? Thanks, teammate.
Yeah.
What a teammate's scales call.
You got it.
Definitely 52-12, but I'll take that.
You done this before?
Just about.
Oh, come on, Matthew. Yeah.
I'll tell you what, he's already over the £100 mark. And there's still one left, one net left to weigh in. I'm going to say that's £54 exactly. Ugh. This is Lee Kerry's final weigh-in. He's already on £107. And I'll tell you what, there's another big weight of fish here.
There's one in. Be nice and gentle with him, lovely.
That margin swim's given you a real boost early, hasn't it? And that is in fact the biggest weigh out of all three, and it's pulled the needle round to £58.
Well done, mate.
Thank you.
There you go, Mr. Kerry.
Thank you, mate. Got
it, I think it's fair to say that's crowned your champion. There you go. That's a fantastic weight of £165 exactly. Well done, Lee.
Thanks very much, Matt.
What an
Cheers.
Exceptional
well done,
mate.
Well done.
Now, I think it's dead interesting. You've both fished different methods throughout the day, and you've both caught lovely nets of fish, 80-odd pound, Emma, and over £100 for Lee.
I think I've been quite lucky, really, because there was some fish on the shallow tactics early.
Yeah.
And also, you know, when they came down the edge, I think, you know, I just sort of got the little bit of a run early on. That, you know, sometimes it works out like that.
That's what
fishing's
all about.
Exactly,
it shows
right,
you that right till the very end of the session, you can still catch some big fish at the end of the day. Or
absolutely, yeah.
That last time was so important.
Yeah, very, very well, Lee. You've booked yourself a nearly draw in the final.
Have I?
Yeah, you certainly have.
Have I got a chance before going in 4 days?
There's a possibility
have. Oh, I've got a chance of a good one then.
But we'll find out in the future. Until then, we'll catch you next time on Absolute Match Fishing.